It's the holiday season, people, and as you can see, I have my Christmas tree out, and if you have a good eye, I have a menorah back there. And no, I'm not culturally confused. One of my parents is a Jewish person, the other one is a Gentile, so we kind of mix it up, but that's not the point of this video. This, however, is, this is what I've been using to edit my H.264 high resolution 4K-ish YouTube videos for the past year and a half. This is a top of the line iMac 5K. For the spec people out there, we got a Core i9 in here, 8-core, Vega 48, 40 gigs of RAM, and this has been amazing for Final Cut so far. But the issue is, not only is the hardware within this computer depreciating faster because of the wonderful M1 Max, like the MacBook Air, which has an M1 chip that competes with the desktop Core i9 in here, but not only that, this desktop has a very old design. We are expecting Apple to completely refresh the iMac line, and this, after they do that, is gonna be worth like $2. No, probably like what the 5K display is worth, and I don't even think you can use it like standalone. So as much as I would like to hang on to this, the depreciation model for Macs has changed, at least with Intel Macs, which is why I've decided to mix things up here to kind of change what I've been doing. And just completely ignore the mess over there. This is my new video editing setup. I'll go into the ultra wide mode here. We have a 4K display that is by no means as good as my iMac 5K, but it's still 350 nits. It's Dell. It has nice thin bezels, unlike my iMac. And then we have the MacBook Pro with the M1 chip, the 13-inch model. This is the baseline one with 8 gigs of RAM. I have ordered a higher spec one with 16 gigs and 512 gigs of internal storage because that's kind of recommended for video editing. But even this is doing a fantastic job, and I just want to show you what I've been doing. So let me just remove this display here. This is the mess that makes everything work. I have this dongle here which attaches to Ethernet and USB data power, all that, and I've been using or video editing like this, not because like I have no choice, but because I like how this works. I have a trackpad right here. I got to get a mouse pad with, for like my magic mouse over here. I feel like I'm not making any sense, but this is what I have been doing. This is how I've been editing for the past like month-ish. No, not month, like 2 weeks, 3 weeks. And I've been really enjoying it. Not only because the M1 in here keeps up and allows me to edit 4K videos, you know, at a decent rate, and you know, it renders the videos just as fast, if not faster than my iMac 5K, but like, it's cheaper. And maybe at the end of the day, if this whole setup costs the same as my iMac 5K, at least I'll know that when a new iMac drops, if I wanna buy that, this will be worth more than the iMac. And honestly, I feel like I'm going on a sort of tangent in this video, but that's sort of the point. I'm really enjoying the portable aspect of this. I have been used to just editing my videos here. I'm at my apartment slash studio, 30 miles away from my parents' house, which I like to frequent because, you know, why not? Like, I don't want to just stay here alone all the time. I love the ability to just, you know, pack this up, bring my external SSD with me, and then work at home at a similar setup with a 4K monitor. I really enjoy that. And the fact that I have iMac 5K level-ish performance, and I'll touch on that in a minute here, the fact that I have that in this small of a device is just fantastic. The fact that it can run Final Cut, the fact that it can run Lightroom and Photoshop, the three apps that I need to make my YouTube videos, that is just crazy to me. The fact that this has just, you know, like the lowest end M series chip with 8 gigs of RAM, again, I'm just gonna say it, it's nuts. Although it's not perfect, it's still doing a fantastic job to, you know, do what I do on a daily basis or a weekly basis. I have one gripe though. While the rendering times are fantastic, and while for the most part I can edit very comfortably, some of the playback can be a bit choppy sometimes, especially when I'm like, have like an overlay of like three high resolution, like 4K clips. I believe that's due to the fact that the M1 has a lesser GPU compared to my Vega 48 iMac. And that's fine. I mean, like, I'm willing to deal with that, with the added benefit of portability and also saving money in the long term, because like I said, this will be worth something once new Macs come out. This will still be desirable, unlike, you know, the chunky Intel equipped iMac that I have back there, despite its amazing 5K display. Yeah, the playback isn't quite as nice, but render times are just as good, if not better. And yeah, that's what I've been doing here. This is not exactly a test video. I'm just sort of reiterating or sharing what I've experienced very generally. If you are a Final Cut editor, I know you might have an expensive Mac. You might have a $6,000 MacBook Pro, Isaac. You might have a $3,000 iMac. You might have something really expensive, and you might be upset about that, but I'm telling you, Get rid of that now. Buy one of these, whether it be a Mac Mini, a MacBook Air, or preferably a MacBook Pro due to its portability, and just use it. It's not gonna be the most perfect case scenario, but I am so impressed with what this has been able to do for me as someone who, you know, is a sort of power user, if you will, somebody who edits in high resolution codecs and whatever you want to say. I definitely recommend just opting for this right now. Jump on board the M1 bandwagon if you are a Final Cut user, and if you do use some Adobe apps. I mean, like, Rosetta is doing an excellent job running those as well. I had no performance issues with Lightroom or Photoshop on this laptop, a baseline MacBook Pro. So if you can, you know, manage to do your creative workflow on here, do it, and possibly wait for an updated MacBook Pro 14 inch or a MacBook Pro 16 inch, or possibly a brand new, beautiful, thin bezeled iMac, which is something I might consider in the future. But yeah, this has served me well. I just wanted to sort of share that in a vlog style video here. So this is what I've been working off of, and I will be going home now, actually. So I'm gonna be, you know, closing this up, putting it into my, you know, bag, and then bringing this home and editing this video that I'm shooting here on that laptop, or on this laptop right here. So that's about it for you guys. I wanted to keep this pretty personal and also just straight to the point and more natural. I will be, once again, buying, if I haven't already said this, a higher end MacBook Pro with 16 gigs of RAM and more internal storage. So I'll share whether or not that's worth getting if you are a Final Cut editor. But yeah, let me just go back to the window there where you can actually see my face. And I'm loving this setup, by the way. I highly recommend you check out my video where I covered this. This is like one of my favorite places in my apartment. I love how open it is. I can just do work out here, not necessarily video editing work, but yeah. And the MacBook Air is just an excellent, excellent device. But anyway, I'd appreciate it if you would leave a like on this video if you want to, comment if you have any questions, suggestions, or opinions, and of course, subscribe for more content like this. We're gonna continue to go on our M1 Mac journey, and also I'll be probably uploading an iPhone 12 mini review at some point, probably an iPad Air 4 accessory type video soon as well. So more content coming in December. And yeah, as always, I'm Noah, and I will catch you all in the next one.